वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा।
Namaste. Welcome to yet another episode of Kala Vishwa Campaign under Horizon series featuring local artists and artisans of state of Goa. Today we have with us Mrs. Deepika Deepak Popkar, who is into fabricating bamboo crafts from bamboo stakes. The art of bamboo craft is believed to have originated from rural areas of Goa. Bamboo craft is believed to be the oldest arts and are widely used for making decorative items in-house. The origin of this art was to cater to bamboo carriers and baskets, which were specially designed for the farmers and fishermen. Farmers carried baskets that used to carry coconut, rice, paddy, fish and flowers. Eventually, this art form with several decorative items like flower pots, pen stands, baskets, lightweight furniture, letter holders, and many such came in wide recognition and acceptance. In a lushy green village of Bicholim, North Goa, resides Mrs. Deepika Popkar, where she weaves baskets and other decorative items like flower vases, wall pieces, hair clips, and the like. Deepika Popkar was introduced to basket weaving at the age of 16 by her sister Sandhya Parab. She began this artwork by helping her sister and eventually started off on her own. With the vast experience of 35 years into this traditional occupation, Deepika is adamant on continuing with her conventional endeavor in spite of all the difficulties. We'll now see what Deepika has to showcase.
The art of bamboo craft is believed to have originated from the rural areas of Goa. The credit particularly goes to the Mahar community. Bamboo craft is believed to be the oldest arts. Both bamboo and crane crafts are widely used for making decorative items in houses. The origin of this art was to cater to bamboo carriers and baskets, which were specially designed for the farmers and fishermen. Farmers carried baskets that used to carry coconut, rice, paddy, fish and flowers. When Goa became one of the major tourist hubs, the art flourished like never before. With several decorative items like flower pots, pen stands, baskets, lightweight furniture and letter holders, this art form is in wide recognition and acceptance. To possess these items, you need to explore Goa beaches or the interiors, and you will be delighted to see the items in your hands. You can always find the tribes indulging in the activity of making beautiful handicrafts, and that is where you get a sense of relief. The craft of bamboo does not involve many tools. The main tool for this art is dao. The complete stem of cane is given an insertion with this tool, which is then further split longitudinally into desired shapes and sizes by a bill hook. Different knives are used in cutting the bamboo. Bamboo craft artists make these products and display them along the roadside, and passers-by purchase them. The use of plastic items such as containers, bags and other products have made our life a lot easier to a great extent, but little is known about its consequences on our environment. Most people use plastic containers these days. Hence, there is a less demand for bamboo products in the markets. Bamboo products are slowly fading away with the latest new generation. As compared to earlier, fishermen and farmers used only products made from local bamboo. Deepika manages to get bamboos and is still engaged in the dyeing art. Goan weddings were incomplete without use of baskets and other items. The process of making these items appears simple, but it's no child's play. Bamboo craft in Goa is concentrated mainly in Bicholim and Asnora districts of North Goa. Department of Handicraft Textiles and Choircraft Complex has set up Bamboo Training Center in Bicholim. Bamboo is an environmentally friendly material that has received much attention in the 21st century. It has a very close and old relationship with mankind. Bamboo craft is believed to be the oldest creation of man and is considered to be the oldest craft which was initiated in Goa region by a community called Mahars. The Mahars introduced items such as valli, which is still used for washing rice and grains. Patlo means a basket which is used for multi-purposes and it is available in many different sizes. Mats or chicks used as curtains or sun protectors and furniture. This craftsman mainly made products which were of use to fishermen during catching of fish and also fabricated a basket in which they could store the dry grains and other food items. These baskets continued to be the bedrock of the craft. Apart from fishermen baskets, many other items like mats, winnowing mats, hats, hen cage, etc. are made which have the traditional techniques with user-centric design. Beauty of bamboo craft lies in its elegant stance. It is simply intricate. Heart of the craft is its weaving. Ethnicity of view give meaning and shape to craft and contributes in its classification. Essence of craft lies in its twin view and its commitment towards making utility-oriented aesthetic products. Cluster is connected to its roots, making the same traditional product with age-old techniques, focusing on the needs of the local community. Bamboo can boost area's economy with appropriate design intervention, which can broaden the local market and can also introduce the same in industrial economy. Bamboo craft has been carried out in families of artisans since decades. Majorly, they follow the same techniques of their ancestors and also explore their own different weaving techniques.
नमस्कार, माझे नाव दीपिका दीपक खोपकर, आव दिवचले रावता. गेली 35 वर्षा आव बांबूचे काम करता आणि हे काम माझी बहीण शिकवण आली आणि आता आम्ही त्याच्या फाटल्यान आम्ही करता. ज्यांका ही कला शिकपाक जाय त्यांका हांव प्रशिक्षणूय दिता. तुमच्या सगळ्यांच्या आशीर्वादान आता पर्यंत हांव हो बिजनेस चलोवपाक शिकलें. हाच्या फुडें तुमची अशीच कृपा आसली अशें हांव देवा लागीं मागतां. देव बरें. हें लाकूड खैरीचे कोणें फोडपा आनी हो म्हाजो कोण्यांचो पळय तो फोडपाचो आनी हो दुसरो आसा तो म्हजो सगळें मोबेळा काडपाचो. हे म्हणजे सुर्यो. ही बारीक बेळा पातळ काडपाची, हे हँडलां लावपाची आनी हे कातर म्हजी कट करपाची. ही सुरी म्हजी बेळा काडपाची, शेंग करपाची, धारो मारपाची. दुसरी सुरी आसा ती हँडलां लावपाची बास्केटी अशें. आनी मागीर म्हजी कातर आसा सगळें कट करपाचें बास्केट. बर हाँ आता एक फिश रेडी करता बांबू पासून आता स्टार्ट केला पाय अर्ध फिश आता हाव बट करता अर्ध बट झालं ठीक लागता आता बोट केला हवे आता बास्केट करता हाँ सगळे रेडी करता बास्केटचे मूळ घालता मोड़ झाले आता पैन करता रेडी झालं फुल पाठ आसू। एरक्लिपा कशे सामके स्ट्रीप जाय पडटा। ओ बर्ड, ये बास्केट, हेयर क्लिप, एक कर्टन तारा लावपाक शकता. एका हांवें शेल वापरल्या, हे मोठे शेल धाकटे, हे बांबूचे बर्ड आनी हे गुंतपाक हांवें ताज वापरला. हे चलो कर्टन, हो हांवें कर्टन तयार केला. एका हांवें सगळे बांबूचे वापरला, हे बर्ड्स वापरल्या, शेल वापरल्या, हे मोठे शेल वापरल्या, भितर एक ताज घेतला आनी हो दाराक लावपाक शकता कर्टन. हँगिंग फ्लाईंग बर्ड, हे बांबू पासून तयार केला, हो बर्ड जालो. एका हँगिंग सूत घातला हांवें आनी ही वायर घातली. हे बांबू पासून तयार केला हांवें, हे फर्स्ट रिंग केला, भितर हांवें बर्ड घातल्या, हे हँगिंग पायप आनी हे ऑल पीस. हे बेळा पासून रिंगा आसा, बर्ड आसा आनी सूत आसा, बर्ड्साचे सूत आसा आनी हे पायप काचीची पायपां घातल्या.
That was a marvelous handicraft showcased by Deepika. In this pandemic, many artists and artisans struggled to make their livelihood, and Deepika was no exception to it. However, notable to mention, Deepika will continue to keep this art form alive. Let us bring home such artworks made by artisans like Deepika and help them sustain their livelihood, their art form, and take a step towards maintaining a green environment. This was it for today. See you in the next episode of Kala Vishwa. Stay happy, stay safe. Namaste.